Physic materials are materials that instead of affecting the appearance of a game object, they affect the way that the object reacts to the physics engine. Consider the difference between the way a basketball and a bowling ball might bounce. Whilst there is a difference in their mass, their surfaces are also very different and they react to other surfaces very differently. Physic materials can be created from the Create button on the project panel. And they're edited in the inspector to control how the surface reacts to another surface. They do this by controlling friction. Dynamic friction is how much friction exists whilst the object is moving, and static friction is how much force is required in order to move the object from a static position. Bounciness does exactly what it sounds like, it controls how bouncy the object is, and the friction combined settings control how they respond to another object with a certain material. Friction direction will allow you to control friction in a particular axis, and the dynamic and static friction 2 properties will give you control over those three axes. In this example, we've applied this particular physic material to our power cube and our workbench. The physic material is applied to the collider in any given game object, and you can see that there's a slot for material within the collider settings. You can see that if I press play, it bounces slightly and is also very slippery. This is because I've put in 0 for dynamic and static friction, meaning there's nothing stopping it from slipping around, and I've also made it slightly bouncy. If I make it very bouncy, then it's going to bounce off of the table. And for example, if I wanted to restrict its movement in a particular axis, so I can see that the x-axis is the direction in which it's sliding. So what I could do is go back to that material and I'll set my friction direction of x to 1 and increase the dynamic friction. I'm going to turn bounciness back down to a lower number so that it doesn't bounce off the table. And you can see that it's slowing to a halt because of the amount of friction involved there. So we could make that slightly lower. And you can see it begins to slide. So hopefully you can see that with physic materials you can completely control the surface of an object and how it responds to others.